Here at the CeBIT, the Huawei Booth. And hello, who are you?
My name is Sushil. I am the marketing manager of these vertical industries, which you can see here. We have the various industries from the transport, smart grid, smart city, smart banking, media industries.
And so Huawei has a huge booth here at the CeBIT, showing a lot of stuff. Let's walk over there.
Sure. We have over hundreds of partners here and around over 150 demo solutions. This is our main booth area where we are doing the MOU signing ceremony with the different partners to have the joint solution development in the future.
And there's a lot of different partners around here. How many
of our ecosystem area? You can see
Intel,
Frequentis, Oracle,
right? All these people are waiting around
this
here.
This one is from the KUKA, one of our partners. They have the one.
This guy's going to play the drums very soon.
Yes, so they are planning to start it soon, it seems.
All right.
And here you can see the list of the partners. These are our Infosys, Hexagon, SAP, T-Systems. And on the left-hand side and the right-hand side, these are all the partner zone. If you see on the your right-hand side,
ISP, cloud, this 26 terabyte, 9 petabyte data.
So this is that we are trying to convert the internet services into the cloud services.
Right.
Connecting the different ecosystems there. And this is about the omni-media.
Let's check once again. Yeah, so here's a media production system.
Yes, media production system to bring the news to the citizens very quickly. On time, and this one.
Let's look at it. Yeah. Here is a showroom. What is that?
You can see here, these are the modules we are using in the ICT infrastructure for our solutions in the different industries.
Over there, you're doing transportation?
Yes, we do. Transportation solutions over there.
Yeah.
Here, over there. Partners and the clients like the DB in the local in Germany.
So you're working with the train company to do
biggest client.
Controlling, managing all that stuff.
Yes, we are providing them railway IoT where you can provide the safe and smooth transition.
Using HoloLens.
The virtualization, you can see all the control, these gateways.
Over here, you're doing a
smart airport, controlling the different sensors and providing the security and providing the different operation and management.
All right.
This
cool.
One is for the smart grid, that how we can save power in the city for each home and for the different sectors.
Cool. And here, I'm looking at a cloud engine. With this is a server stuff.
Yes, this is a server cloud engine 12800, which is the most fast here. And in this area, you can see the different technology section. Our technology, our server, switches, storage system.
Huawei is a leader in all this stuff. Right?
Yeah, Huawei is leading the new ICT. Our logo is also saying the same thing, leading new ICT and the road to the digital transformation. So we are trying to bring transformation digitally into the different industries and the sectors.
What is that?
This one is our Fusion Cube for the data center. We have the Fusion Cube, Fusion Sphere, Fusion Server, which are connecting and managing this data center ICT infrastructure devices.
Nice. Big data, cloud, and the smart module. Let's go in there.
Yes, so you can see here, this is, you can manage the data center efficiently, control. This is our Fusion Module 2000.
Manage the data center?
Yes, for the operation and management of the data center. You can see it's efficient, reliable.
Yeah. So in here is actually...
These are our different racks, so you can put your storage ICT infrastructure into this and we can manage it more efficiently, see the hierarchy of all the modules.
What's going on with the smart city?
Yes, so smart city, we are trying to make the nerve system for the smart city.
Yeah.
Here, so as human body has a nerve system with the brain, so we are making the CT as a nerve system with the brain as an IoC module. I will show you there. And you can see here in a smart city, we have the different industries.
The like stuff going on here with NB-IoT.
Module being done,
it's called KUKA 150 for NB-IoT. You work on this. You have this right here. That's a big deal in the future, right?
Yes, so IoT is bringing up a huge transformation in the different industries. It is coming into the smart buildings. This is for this. I don't
know. It's inside here. It is basically there can be IoT in the. You scan it here, and you can take the bicycle.
Take the bicycle. If you finish, you scan your game, and you calculate the fees in your mobile.
That's cool, yeah. And it's working over NB-IoT.
Yeah.
That's fantastic. That's a really cool system. So there's already big quantities. Yeah. Here is Huawei. So what is Huawei doing with NB-IoT?
We use our HIPAA operator to deploy the IoT services with this technology. Huawei provides the wireless
chipset
and end-to-end solution.
And how does it work in here?
And so far, the generation of this log is based on this, just like this.
NB-IoT?
This is first generation. Yeah. Now, second generation, we want to use the NB-IoT module inside. And
this is NB-IoT.
Yeah, NB-IoT module inside. And right. When user wanted to use the bicycle, they just scan this the QR and get the password.
Because in China, there's a lot of sharing of bicycle, right?
Yes, yes.
Many.
So far, there are 10 million.
10 million shared bicycles.
10 million bicycle, and every day there are more than 100 million. I don't know, 100, 10 million, 10 million.
So is this solution is ready?
Solution
is launched?
So far, a lot of the more than, okay.
There. Q1, Q3?
Yes. So far, there are, by the end of this year, there are more than 30 network, NB-IoT network will be able to deploy it. So now, and yes. So now. So here I want just to want to show this fireman tracing demo. So there's this trigger, and the fireman can wear this suit, and maybe the inside of the suit.
Inside the suit.
Yeah, yes, and we can to
see where you are inside the room.
Yeah,
inside.
And then the NB-IoT can translate all of the sensor information to the APP server. APP server map this digital map to get where is this fireman, and is there some problem with this the fireman?
And here.
We just want to say, if we get this a lot of information with the NB-IoT, we can to translate all the information to the video surveillance platform and to push to talk to every some of the users.
Nice. So Huawei is ready to be at the forefront of NB-IoT that's coming, the future of IoT.
Yes, and Huawei, I think this NB-IoT will be large massively to deploy in the world. So right. Huawei can to promote this ecosystem and network sites.
Cool, okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you. Cool, so that was a cool demo around here.
So this is for the single window government services. So if there are, in the government we have many problems for, we need to go to the service center, stand in the long queue, but here you can just go to any window. Yes, you can do it by yourself, swipe card login. So you can, so when you swipe in, you can, so you can get all the service guide and you can do it by yourself in this self-service machine.
Nice. Okay. Let's walk around some more. Yes. There's even more. There was more NB-IoT right here. I was
looking at it.
You have it in the suitcase. There's a whole ecosystem.
This is for the suitcases. The sensors can track the information and this information will go to the IoT controller where you can drive the various applications based on these IoT's gateways.
All kinds of automation.
Yes, this is for the ocean connecting the manufacturing domain.
Let's check the smart classroom.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm moving around a lot. Right.
Smart classroom. Yeah. In the smart classroom, you can see that you can join this classroom from the remote location, like in the real time. The teacher is in the Shenzhen. Yes. And we can join this classroom, and it will be very interactive, as if you are really in the Shenzhen and teaching, studying
nice.
With the teacher.
Cool. And medical?
Yeah, this one is also the medical health cloud.
Yeah.
So, for example, these devices, so you are at in your area, but the doctor can get the reports in the another location. So you see on the other side, so the doctor is another location, but I am here in my home. So the doctor can see all the report, what is happening to this patient, and he can give some precaution or some medicine.
Nice.
So
let's
the patient don't need to go to the hospital, but can be done remotely also. And this is for the smart building. You can see there are a lot of sensors, and these sensors, like in the smart building, to save the power or the temperature, humidity, you can control in one time. And we have very interesting one here. So this is for the intelligent facial recognition. So you can track the person's face when you are detecting. You can so you see that this it can detect that where we have been moved to and all the location and the
cameras are
cameras.
On the booth.
Yes, they are all around, and then they will trace the path that where this person
nice.
Has been moved.
Can you find me?
Yeah. Conditions such as.
Okay, there's a lot of people down here who need to find me. Then you can see where I was.
So you need to look there.
I'm right there.
Is the red color and the static search. This is the result.
There, I'm there.
Just select the
okay, yeah, so yeah. You can see where I was.
The video is longer than we have.
You can
maybe
see
we have several
nice.
Results and all the results.
Cool.
Will be
that's awesome.
And
cool.
And you can see the recorded video of that particular place. So we are.
That was me. That you've come in, so you are moving.
That was before.
Yes,
was
so it has recorded the one at this location.
That's
so
fantastic, right?
Yes. So you
that's
can
the
find
leading system for security camera.
Yes, the fast and efficient resolving.
Cool. It's the software E2. Who's E2?
E2 is our partner who is providing the software.
You work in E2?
Yeah, I work for E2.
Uh-huh. So is this deployed? People
yeah.
can buy can have this solution now?
Yes, we have. This has already been deployed for China government.
In China?
Yeah.
How about other country?
We are working with the various projects in other country, like in Middle East, Europe. In Europe, we have just POC, but mainly it is being deployed in
is it
Middle
on the
East.
Cloud or is it local?
Well, the deployment could be based on the cloud or based on the physical servers. Both
and
okay
is
for
it
us.
4K security camera and 4K?
No,
or no, need?
No, just
no need?
Normal camera is okay.
Normal camera.
2 mega. Yeah.
That's very, very cool.
But you see, we also have the 4K ultra high definition scenarios.
Yeah. That's also 4K right here.
Yeah, so it can detect the person's face from very far locations. It can be used in parking lots and other small places where you want to recognize the person in detail.
And it's recording 4K,
yeah.
8 megabit per second, H.265.
Yeah.
What is the chipset?
Chips from Huawei.
High silicon.
Yeah.
And this is the new one.
This is also 4K.
Yes,
4K.
Also 4K. 4K now.
Yeah.
So is inside the this one?
This one is a 4K. Okay.
That one there. All right. So it's ready.
These are our new cameras released in 2017.
Nice. Is a good price. Yeah. Everybody should get 4K security camera, right?
Yeah.
Cool. All right.
And
thanks.
This one is also very cool. The virtualization.
Yeah.
You can see here. So you can have the real experience, and you can control it.
All right, that's VR with a.
Yes.
But we
you
wanna
can,
check.
You can VR it.
Whoa.
Maybe you can control this.
Welcome to the VR experience.
So this is the virtual reality experience, and you can see here how, in the emergency response, we can manage the emergency.
Yeah, let's check if this, we can do this demo, right there, with Hexagon, also another partner, right?
Cool. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, so, this is at the, yes, and this is at the remote, and the scene in place, so you can see that something has happened, and the person has gone out the field. Report an alarm.
It's basically a simulation of a real-world situation, maybe.
Sorry?
simulating what could happen in the real world.
Yes, yes. So when you VR, you feel you are really on the scene place, and it will give you the end-to-end flow and how it will experience you in the real time.
Nice. Okay, let's check this wall out over here. Intelligent operating system. There's a lot of people around here.
Yes, so you can see that this is our one of the biggest highlight in the smart city solution, yeah. Where this smart city, this intelligent operation center, yeah. is acting like a brain of the smart city. So you can have the decision making here. So
let's get closer over there to the command center.
So you can, how does it work? You can control with this dashboard, and you can see the real status of the city in the real time. And you can control the different command control center, like emergency for ambulance, police or fire, consolidate it together.
Can you click on something?
So
right now you are changing the mode to, this is Beijing.
So you see, yes, this is one of the city in China, and you can choose the, your interest things, and if you want to open education population, or you want to see the firefighting, or the different surveillance cameras, or the airport, and you can choose some security camera, and you can focus on what is happening in the real time at that particular
location. Is this for real? Is this ready?
Yes, this has been deployed already in one of the city in China, and for other cities, we are have some in process.
So basically the mayor should have this in his office.
Yes.
He can control everything from his office.
Yes, and he can make some, he can control on this dashboard, or also he can see this from his iPad, or even in emergency we can make a call to his mobile.
This is like a movie, but it's for real.
Yeah, this is real.
It's real. So a lot of cool stuff, and this is a highlight, one of the highlights
of the smart city.
Ready to manage every aspect of the city.
Yes.
And turn everything connected, right?
Yes, and turning the smart city into the real one, which you are expecting from the different sensors. So it turns your ideas into the reality, and turn the city into really smart cities.
Nice, and this is just the beginning. Huawei is doing a lot, but there's gonna be so much more in the future,
yes,
right?
Yes, we are working with various partners, and many more partners are coming into our ecosystem, and we expect that we can work together with the partners to bring the innovation to the industry.
Cool. Can you show something here?
I can show the coolest demo. Yeah, show the coolest demo. Let's try.
You can use your fingers to...
He's also our partner.
Nice.
...zoom out. And if you... this show some camera icon.
Let's see where the police cars are.
Yes, this is police car. You can click this. And there's a blue icon, it's police car.
This is not in real time, right? This is a simulation, right?
Yes, a simulation.
But this is for real in Beijing?
Yes. Yes, it's for real.
It's for real?
Yes. If you click the camera...
You can see all the security cameras.
Yes, yes. I'm going to see the security cameras.
They can be a facial recognition on people moving around the city, see where they are, where they've been, where they're going.
Maybe. Yeah.
Maybe.
Yes, we can use that software which we have seen before to deploy into this solution, and we can trace the person's history, and it will help us to resolve the cases quickly.
And you can see the subway stations, choose subway.
Yes, we can choose, and you
and
see
railway.
The different...
And now you can see all the traffic.
You can also get the statistic information about population, education, regional GDP, people's income, the different static information. It will help you to do the city planning in a better way. So, for example, you want to open a school, you can choose a location where it is more suitable.
You need to manage traffic and pollution levels.
You can
and,
see the pollution
tell
level
tell people
also.
To get on other routes maybe to
yes,
spread around
that
the
city
a little
helpful.
Bit.
To,
and,
yes.
And manage traffic from the central office, the management control center.
Yes, the citizens can get the messages in advance that this route is busy, so they can choose another alternate ways.
And all this is going through the cloud?
Yes, this all is deployed in the cloud.
Great.